إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن نبينا وحبيبنا محمد رسول الله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحابته ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا ثم أما بعد إخوة الإيمان والإسلام My dear respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam نودع شهرا كريما شهر شعبان هذا الشهر الذي كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يصوم معظمه ولما سئل عن ذلك قال ذاك شهر ترفع فيه الأعمال إلى الله عز وجل قال ذاك شهر يغفل عنه الناس بين رجب ورمضان وهو شهر ترفع فيه الأعمال إلى الله عز وجل وأحب أن يرفع عملي وأنا صائم فهذه واحدة بين توديع شعبان والواحدة الأخرى بين استقبال شهر كريم بل هو أعظم الشهور وأكرمها شهر رمضان فنحن بين مكرمتين وهذا يحتاج إلى وظيفتين مهمتين Brothers and sisters, we are bidding farewells to the month of Sha'ban, this blessed month that Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam would fast most of it, almost most of it. And when he was asked, why was he fasting? Why he did practice the practice of fasting? He said, "Qala, this month, most of people, the majority of people, they are neglectful of. They are heedless of. It's fadila, it's greatness. And it's also the a'mal are being presented and finally submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I love that my a'mal, my good deeds, are presented or to be presented while I'm in a state of siyam. So this is something, this is one of the obligations or one of the duty of our time that we are leaving away the month of Sha'ban, which is from the categorization of the a'mal being presented to Allah, it is the last of month. So we are leaving it away and we are in the same time receiving the month of Ramadan. So we are in need of two duties to fulfill and two obligations that we need to fulfill and to do the best and maximize our potentials regarding these two things. Leaving away Sha'ban and preparing for the month of Ramadan, receiving it with the best preparations. So let me begin with the preparations for the month of Ramadan. I will come back to the leaving away or bidding farewells to the month of Sha'ban. Briefly, I'm sharing with you some advice, some tips, some steps, some principles that we need to make in order to receive the Ramadan the best receiving and also to benefit from the month and not to be of those who will be deprived of the month. May Allah Azza wa Jal save us. In most of our worldly things that we do, so usually people, they make preparations and they warm up, what they call as warm up. So the soccer match, so they have preparations before and they also have plans and they have goals. So when it comes to the month of Ramadan, it is something that is, so great that we need to make also these plans, subhanAllah, from a spiritual and religious perspective. So to make it close to our minds. So to start, these preparations start from the heart. سيدنا أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه كان يقول: بمحلوف رسول الله ما أتى على المسلمين شهر خير لهم من رمضان. He is saying, I'm holding qasam or oath, the same oath that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam held or took, that there is no month that comes upon people or true Muslims or true believers like the month of Ramadan. So there is no month that has khair and goodness like the month of Ramadan, and this is for the believers. And he says, and there is no month that has shar for the or comes upon people and has shar for the hypocrites like Ramadan. So wal-iyadu billah, so for the believers, they find, you know, goodness in the month. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, وَإِذَا مَا أُنزِلَتْ سُورَةٌ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ أَيُّكُمْ زَادَتْهُ هَذِهِ إِيمَانًا. So the believers, they have istibshar, they have joy, they have happiness. They are spiritually excited for the month of Ramadan or for any goodness and blessed seasons that are coming. So we need to be of those. And be aware, don't be of the like wal-iyadu billah, those who have hypocrisy, and they have the characteristics of hypocrites regarding this month, because they become lazy, they are inactive, they don't want to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So be aware of these things. So starting from the heart, we need to make the preparations. So to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first to revive our hearts. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam in the hadith, إن الإيمان يخلق كما يخلق الثوب. The iman becomes old or becomes weak or becomes like that thawb that we have, the cloth that we have, it becomes old as well. It's not brand new. So the iman also like this. So what should we do, ya Rasulullah? قال فاسألوا الله أن يجدد الإيمان في قلوبكم. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to revive iman, refresh iman in your hearts. So starting from the heart, warming up from the heart, preparations by the heart. Coming closer to Allah, drawing near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the more we come close to Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be closer. And the more we come fast to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we draw fast to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will be more and more subhanahu wa ta'ala. In a hadith, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam narrates from his عن رب العزة جل وعلا: إذا تقرب العبد إلي شبرا تقربت إليه ذراعا، وإذا تقرب إلي ذراعا تقربت منه باعا، وإذا أتاني يمشي أتيته هرولة. رواه البخاري. Which means Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam narrates that Allah azza wa jal says, when a slave of mine draws near to me a span, or the space of a span, I draw near to him a cubit. And if he or she draws near to me a cubit, I draw near to him a fathom. And if he comes to me walking, I go to him or her running. So in a way that implies that Allah Azza wa Jal responds to us so quickly, subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is a reaction, there is a communication between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the opposite is correct. If someone doesn't care, if someone is turning away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنِ الْعَالَمِينَ. So starting from the heart, we need to revive our hearts. Having the doing like Nabi Musa alayhi salam. Allah Azza wa Jal promised an appointment to Sayyidina Musa with his people to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَقَالَ وَمَا أَعْجَلَكَ عَنْ قَوْمِكَ يَا مُوسَى. O Musa, what made you hastened or in rush to come to the appointment, leaving your people of Bani Israel behind you? فَقَالَ هُمْ أُولَاءِ عَلَىٰ أَثَرِي. O Allah, they are close to me, close on my track. They are coming after me. وَحَجِلْتُ إِلَيْكَ رَبِّي لِتَرْضَى. Ya Allah, I hasten to you. I came in rush to you, to your meeting or appointment with you, so that I please you, Ya Allah. So that was Nabi Musa alayhi salam. Two lessons we learn from this ayah and from this action that Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam did. Two main lessons: that we have some people or friends who may drag us or to make us lag behind, to not to race or compete in doing good deeds. So for those types of company or friends, you have to make like Sayyidina Musa, to leave them behind. So to rush to do the right thing, to hasten to do the khairat. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَىٰ مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. So to race, to compete, we are in a competition. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam would say, Ramadan suq qama thumma fad. It's like a market. like an auction, something in a way that is close to our minds with the big difference or distinction of the greatness of the month. So قَامَ ثُمَّ فَاد, so that comes and goes. رَبِحَ فِيهِ مَنْ خَسِرْ مَنْ رَبِحْ وَخَسْرَ فِيهِ مَنْ خَسِرْ. So there are some who will be profitable, so there are some who are progressors, or some who are losers, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. Allah Azza wa Jal says, and he mentions in a number of ayat, that the beginning comes from his servant, from us, and all the response comes directly from Allah. فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Mention me, or remember me, I will remember you. So if you remember Allah in Sha'ban, Allah will remember you in Ramadan. If you remember Allah today, Allah will not leave you today or tomorrow or anytime. اُدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. So supplicate. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pray to me, I will respond to you. So this is very important step that we need to make. Revive our hearts. To refresh the iman in our hearts. Supplicate to Allah. Come close to Allah. Hasten, hasten to fix yourself for the month before the month comes. And the ulama, they talk about this as, they call it as عَوَامِلُ بَعْثِ الشَّوْقِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. عَوَامِلُ بَعْثِ الشَّوْقِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. The factors or the things that we need to do in order to increase our yearning, increase our spiritual desire, increase our excitement toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they mention some of the things throughout the Quran and Sunnah that in revive this yearning or this desire in our heart, which actually the strength, the power of a believer is in his or her heart. The power is in the heart actually, subhanallah, the spiritual power. So one of the factors is to reflect on and meditate or have understanding regarding Asma'ullah al-Husna. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-Halim, the forbearing, the one who leaves us, and he leaves us when we do wrong things. He delays us not to be punished until we repent. Ismullahi al-Tawwab, the one who frequently accepts our repentance. Ismullahi al-Wadud, the loving ones. Ismullahi al-Halim, Ismullahi al-Ghafur, Ismullahi al-Razzaq, Ismullahi al-Muqeed. So these beautiful and lofty attributes of Allah, reflect over this. So this is one of the factors that bring and increase the iman and the shawq toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart. Another factor, mutala'atu ni'amillahi al-'azima wa ala'ihi al-jasima. Falqulubu mashbulatun 'ala hubbi man ahsana ilayha. Wa kullama izdadta 'ilman bi ni'amillahi 'alayk, kullama izdadta shawqan li shukri Allahi 'ala ni'ma'ihi. So to reflect upon and to ponder over the ni'am that Allah continues to give to you, the bounties, the great ni'am that you have. And we need to delve into the ni'am that are hidden, and that they are many more than the apparent ni'am. Subhanallah, the ni'mah of iman, the ni'mah of hidayah, the ni'mah of Quran, the ni'mah of Islam, the ni'mah of safety, security, the ni'mah of, you know, if you think you will check yourself, you will find many ni'am in your innumerable ni'am. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you count, if you come to count the ni'am of Allah, you will never ever be able to enumerate them. Yet, what is the problem? إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَظُلُومٌ كَفَّارٌ. The insan is zalum for himself. He is doing wrongdoing. He is a wrongdoer. And he is kaffar وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is one of the factors. The more you reflect over the ni'am, the having knowledge about this, the more thankful and grateful to Allah you will be. And think about something that I have learned and experienced in my life. If someone is ungrateful to Allah, that means that Allah is ungrateful and unhappy with him. Astaghfirullah. If someone is ungrateful to Allah, it means that Allah is not happy with him or her. If you are happy with Allah, so that means that Allah is happy with you. So this, look at this and think about. So this is one of the factors. Number one, Asma'ullahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a great act of worship and a great factor in our religion, in the Quran and Sunnah, right? To connect ourselves to Allah, Asma'ullahi al-Husna. Then, Ni'amullahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, number three, At-tahassuru ala fawati al-azminati wal-awqati fi ghayri ta'atillah. Allah continues to to give us ni'am, blessings, bounties and favors, and in the same time we are making the wrong things. So mutala'atul jinaya, we are having taqseer, we are not fulfilling our obligations, our duties, whether regarding ourselves, whether regarding our parents, whether regarding our brothers and sisters, our children, as a father, as a son, as a Muslim, as a citizen, as a human being. Illa man rahim Allah. Say mutala'atul jinaya, to think about the crimes that you make, the mistakes that you make, in the same time that the ni'am Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives to you. This is one of the factors that make you thinking about yourself and make you aware of what are the mistakes that you have. And this is one of the steps that we need also to put in our plans. What mistakes I have, I need to fix during the month of Ramadan to be of your goals. And what are the plans that I should take? Because many a times we say, okay, I want to be saved from the hellfire, I want Jannah, and I want to read Quran. These are goals, mashallah. But what are the plans? What are the plans, my brothers and sisters, that you take to achieve these goals and these ultimate objectives? So we need to have plans. We need to prepare ourselves. What the time that you will sacrifice? What the efforts that you will make? So that is the matter. So one of the factors to bring the desire and to bring love and to bring excitement in our hearts toward this blessed month is to look at the races and those who are competing in ta'at. So people in this world are categorized into poor, into rich, wealthy, less fortunate. So in the akhirah, people are categorized based on their a'mal as well. Someone who, out of the heat of the sun is very close to the heads of the people in the day of judgment. Someone is drowning in his sweat. He is sweating to the extent that he or she is gonna drown. And someone, he is shaded under the throne of Ar-Rahman. So which one would you love to be? That is based on your a'mal here. That is based in your preparations here. Month of Ramadan is an opportunity to get this fadila and this degree. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who will be shaded under her throne in the day of judgment. So one of the factors is to look at yourself. Subhanallah, I'm running too late. And there are many, mashallah, who have prepared for the month. They have fixed many things in themselves. They are competing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. And this should make you cry because of your hal and your condition. This regretting is in itself an achievement. This regretting to fix yourself and to sit and meditate about your hal, your condition toward your deen and toward Allah, wallahi, is a success in and of itself. So to reflect over your hal toward and in comparison to those who are racing and competing in doing the ta'at, reading the Quran during the month of Ramadan. My dear respected brothers and sisters, this is the first principle and preparations of suit of preparations that we need to make to spiritually by our hearts revive our iman, having shawq, yearning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do the right thing during the month of Ramadan, to do a good job during the month of Ramadan. The month of Ramadan is, one of the ulama, he gave an example. It's like someone who went to the auction, just to taqriba lil fahm, to make it close to our understanding. So someone went to the auction and he found a brand new car. This car, before the auction was made or offered, so it was $1 million. And he said, wow, I can't buy this car. And then the following week, he found it in the auction with only $10,000. So think about this person. If he will leave this car, it is like as a person who has Ramadan. Subhanallah, Ramadan is a very precious gift and blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you can gain something that is very, very expensive in only 30 days or 30 nights. So you can gain 30 opportunity of dua, 30 opportunity of emancipation from the hellfire, 30 opportunity of success in this world and the hereafter. Yet you are not taking advantage of this offer. Subhanallah. May Allah Azza wa Jal grant us the understanding. So that takes us to the next principle. in order to prepare for the month of Ramadan is to recognize and to understand the fadila of the mawasim, the blessing, the virtue, the merits of the mawasim that Allah grants to us, that Allah favors us with. In a short time throughout the year, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us this in order to be raised in ranks, in order to be forgiven, in order to survive spiritually, physically, subhanAllah, in many aspects, benefits we gain during the month of Ramadan. قال النبي in hadith رواه الطبراني من حديث محمد بن مسلمة إن لله في أيام الدهر نفحات فتعرضوا لها فلعل أحدكم أن تصيبه نفحة فلا يشقى بعدها أبدا. So which means in the days of Allah there are nafahat, blessings and bounties that Allah gives to us. So present yourselves to this nafahat. Why? So that may or perhaps one of you will be granted any nafha of these blessings, any blessing of these seasons and blessed month, and he will never ever be unhappy or have shaqa or miserliness here or there. قال الإمام ابن رجب في كتاب لطائف المعارف فيما لمواسم العام من الوظائف. This is a great reference in order for a person to know the blessings and the fadail of the month. He says, فالسعيد من اغتنم مواسم الشهور والأيام والساعات. السعيد, the real happy person, is a person who makes اغتنام, he takes advantage of the blessed seasons, the blessed days and the blessed hours. وتقرب فيها إلى مولاه بما فيها من وظائف الطاعات. And he comes close to Allah, make devotions of أعمال by طاعات and good deeds. فعسى أن تصيبه نفحة من تلك النفحات. Perhaps, inshallah, for sure, he will be granted a نفحة, blessing from these blessings. And فينجو بذلك من النار وما فيها من اللفحات. And because of that, he will be saved and emancipated from the hellfire and what it has of the blazing fire. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. So to understand and to recognize what blessed season and month that we are receiving and that is visiting us very soon, which is the month of Ramadan. يَا فَوْزَ الْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ أَسْتَغْفِرُوا أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ الْعَظِيمَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد. So number one, to revive our hearts, to come close to Allah. Number two, to recognize the seasons, the blessed seasons and month that Allah gives to us. Number three, to have like tamarin, trainings, to have like warming up. تمارين الهمة والعزيمة. نبي عليه الصلاة والسلام, when he make قيام الليل, he would start with two light rak'ahs. The sunan that we have before the salah. So this is as a form of warming up for the farida in itself. So the reason that many fail during the month of Ramadan or don't reap the complete fruits during the month of Ramadan, why? Because they end up with the month. They end up with fasting with the people, praying Taraweeh, and that's why you find, mashallah, the masajid are full during the first, two, third, or fourth nights, and then empty, and then they start to come again. So there is no plan. There is no, what are the goals that you want to achieve? There is no plan that are set. There is no plans that are specific plans for people to achieve, and this person, kind of person, definitely will not benefit the best. Benefits from the month. May Allah Azza wa Jal save us. So to have a share from Qiyam al-Layl. From now, start from this night, at least two rak'ahs, four rak'ahs. Start reading Quran. Start making dhikr and istighfar. Start think about yourself. Start reflect about the taqseer regarding obligations and duties that you have. As a father, as a mother, as a son, as a student, as a person, subhanAllah, who is responsible in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the reasons or the principles of preparations as well that I mentioned before, which is to list our mistakes that we need to fix during the month of Ramadan. And this will be one of the goals that we need to achieve. Someone who has diseases in his heart, someone who delays his salah, someone who doesn't read Quran. Quran is not something that is in his heart. So someone who doesn't respect his parents, someone who is falling short regarding many obligations and duties. So, and to list all these things and to work, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow you to make and fix this, and also ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you taking the plans to make these things. One of the reasons or the steps of preparing for the month of Ramadan is to study about the virtue of the month of Ramadan, to evaluate the month. I heard that one of the wealthiest people in the world, if there is $100 fell down from him on the ground, on the floor, if he, you know, went down to bring it, he will lose hundreds of thousands of dollars. So those people understand the value of time. So, but unfortunately, we don't understand the value of such month that we have. So from a spiritual perspective, from a recognition of the favors that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to think about this and to spend a time to reflect over these things. And lastly, still we have an opportunity in the month of Sha'ban, my brothers and sisters, to make a tawbah and to make istighfar. And this is one of the best things that we can conclude and bid farewells or leave away the month of Sha'ban. Make tawbah and istighfar before the month of Sha'ban goes. Make tawbah and istighfar before the month of Ramadan comes. Nabi alayhi salatu was salam, our role model, he would make tawbah and istighfar more than 100 times a day. Ya ayyuhan nas, tubu ila Allah, wastaghfiruh, fa inni atubu ila Allah fil yawmi akthar min 100 marra. I make tawbah more than 100 times. And that was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes, subhanahu wa ta'ala, lallahu ashaddu farahan bitawbati abdihi min ahadikum ka saqata ala ba'irihi wa qad adallahu fi ardin fala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes more delighted and more joyful, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in a way that suits his majesty when a person of us repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't you want to be happy, Allah be happy with you? So definitely we want. So you must make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah azza wa jal makes during the first night of Ramadan, it's a very, very special night, the first night in the month of Ramadan. Don't miss and don't be neglectful or heedless of. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam mentions that from the very, very beginning of the month of Ramadan, which is the first night of Ramadan, تُفَتَّحُ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ وَتُغَلَّقُ أَبْوَابُ النَّارِ, the doors of Jannah are opened and the doors of the hellfire are made close, are shut, and the shayateen are shackled, and the doors of mercy are opened as well in different narrations. وَيُنَادِي مُنَادٍ يَا بَاغِيَ الْخَيْرِ أَقْبِلْ, O seeker of goodness and ta'at, proceed and come forward, hasten. وَيَا بَاغِيَ الشَّرِّ أَقْصِرْ, and O seeker of sins, O seeker of neglectfulness, O seeker of bad things, أقصر, stop and don't continue. And وَلِلَّهِ عُتَقَاءُ وَذَلِكَ فِي كُلُّ لَيْلَةٍ, and there are عُتَقَاءُ from the hellfire, and this is each and every night. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the understanding to prepare for the month of Ramadan. إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات المؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات اللهم ردنا إلى دينك مردا جميلا اللهم ردنا إلى دينك مردا جميلا تب علينا لنتوب اللهم اغفر لنا الذنوب اللهم استر لنا العيوب اللهم فرج الكروب اللهم انصر دينك وكتابك وسنة نبيك وعبادك الصالحين فرج كروب المسلمين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها اللهم بلغنا رمضان اللهم بلغنا رمضان ووفقنا فيه للعتق من النيران اللهم تقبل منا الأعمال تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. ارحم أمواتنا واشف مرضانا وأمراض المسلمين. اللهم اعف عنا وسامحنا يا رب العالمين. ربنا أنجي المستضعفين من المسلمين في كل مكان. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد، والحمد لله رب العالمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم.